بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد، نكونتيني بإذن الله. أما بعد، أول شيء السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We continue with our first class will be شرح زاد المستقنع, then the مقاصد of the شريعة, and we end إن شاء الله this evening with علم السلوك or the book of ابن تيمية, شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمة الله عليه, وهي التحفة العراقية, in the action of the heart and also the disease of the heart. Starting إن شاء الله with the شرح of زاد المستقنع, we continue with some of the ruling concerning al-imama and the salat al-jama'ah. Last time we stopped concerning some of the salat that of the ma'moon which will be accepted or not. So just read where we left off that before that, and then we will continue inshallah ta'ala. يقول المصنف رحمه الله تعالى, I will be starting reading that a part that we already did last time. ولا تصح خلف فاسق ككافر. The prayer is not accepted, is not sound behind a فاسق ككافر. فاسق, someone who is deviated from the path, and the deviation from the path can be from someone who is sinning to someone who is out of Islam. قال ولا تصح خلف فاسق ككافر ولا امرأة وخنثى للرجال ولا صبي لبالغ وأخرس ولا عاجز عن ركوع أو سجود أو قعود أو قيام. We already explained all this, but just go through the translation. Salat is not accepted or is not valid to be prayed behind someone who is fasiq, someone who is deviated, like someone who is ungrateful, a disbeliever, and also behind when the imam is a woman. And we explained the ruling and all the opinion around that. وَخُنْثَ لِلرِّجَالِ, وَخُنْثَ is the one that is by nature is not known to be a male or female, and this is all those when they are leading the man. ولا صبي لبالغ, and not also for a صبي, a young boy, لبالغ, for someone who already reached the age of puberty. And we mentioned all the different of opinion of the scholar concerning that. وأخرس, and the أخرس is the one who cannot hear, الأخرس cannot speak. الأخرس, he the one who cannot speak, therefore he cannot recite the Quran too, so he will be able to read. ولا عاجز عن ركوع أو سجود أو قعود, and not someone who's not able to make ركوع or سجود or قعود, so he will not able to make these stances, the pillar of the prayer, so he cannot be an imam. إلا إمام الحج المرجو وزوال إلته. Imam al-Hayy, the one who's the imam that is known and appointed imam in the masjid. When he is sick for some time, therefore the salat behind him, it will be valid. Why? Because yurja zawala illatih. He's hoping that inshaAllah ta'ala Allah will heal him. But for someone who's handicapped, crippled, you know, he will not be able to be an imam. Why? Because the one who be fulfilling the pillar of the salat, he will be the one who's, you know, who had the right of the, to be advanced to lead. قال ويصلون وراءه جلوسا, and they pray behind him sitting down. And we mentioned قال ندبا, ندبا is mean recommended. فإن ابتدأ بهم قائما ثم اعتل فجلس أتموا خلفه قياما وجوبا. Now, if he started standing and then he felt sick, and after feeling sick, he had to sit down. Therefore, everyone as ma'mumin praying behind him, they have by obligation to continue their prayer on their own position, which is standing. They should not sit, because the imam started with them, you know, standing. But if he start with them sitting, therefore, the recommended that they sit behind him. They sit, if he sit, they sit from the beginning. And we mentioned all the saying and the opinion of the scholars last time about that. قال وتصح خلف من به سلس البول بمثله. And the one who has a problem of he cannot control his urine, so سلس البول, the one who cannot control his urine, therefore he's not able to hold his wudu. And for such ones or such people who have this disease, they make wudu before the salah. They make wudu before the salah, regardless of the continuous drops that they have from the urine, which is causing them to usually to not have wudu and to have their clothes to be impure. But because of the rahmah of the Sharia, such a condition, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave for them the permission because of the disease that they have that they cannot control. But such a person cannot lead the prayer. Such a person cannot lead the prayer. But he only can lead for someone who's like him, who has the same disease like him. He can lead the prayer because they have the same condition. That's why قَالَ وَتَصَحُّ خَلْفَ مَنْ بِهِ سَلَسُ الْبَوْلِ بِمِثْلِهِ. And the prayer is valid for the one who has a problem of urine or he cannot control his urine, leading someone like him. وَلَا تَصَحُّ خَلْفَ مُحْدِثٍ وَلَا مُتَنَجِّسٍ يَعْلَمُ ذَلِكَ. And it's not valid or sound or accepted the salat behind someone who doesn't have wudu, behind someone who has an impurity, knowing that he has it, knowing that he has it. So someone who doesn't have wudu and leading, and the one who's behind him know that he doesn't have wudu, so his salat is not accepted. Someone is praying and seeing someone who has impurity in his clothes, and the person who's leading, he doesn't know, but the one who's being led, he knows, so his salat is not accepted. You know why? Because he knows that he has impurity, so he has to let him know. فَإِنْ جَهَلَ هُوَ وَالْمَأْمُومُ حَتَّى انْقَضَتْ صَحَّتْ لِمَأْمُومٍ وَحْدَهُ. So in both of them, they didn't know about the presence of the impurity, or the imam didn't know that he's, for example, state of janabah, as we mentioned the example of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he only found out after the, it was in Salat al-Fajr, it was dark, so he could not see his clothes, and after the light started to come up, he saw some traces of water on his, on his clothes. So he realized that he had an impurity. He was in a state of janaba. In this case, the salat of al-ma'mum is sahih. The one who's, who's led in the prayer, the ma'mum, his salat is sound as well. He doesn't have to repeat it. But the imam, he has to repeat his prayer. The imam, he has to repeat his prayer. Someone, for example, reading the prayer and he didn't know that, he forget that he didn't have wudu, and he only remembered after the prayer was finished. Therefore, in this case, the people who prayed with him, their salat is sahih. But him, for him, he would not ask them to repeat their prayer because they didn't know and he didn't know. Therefore, both of them, their salat for the ma'mumin is sound and valid, but for the imam, he has to repeat his prayer. That's what he said. قَالَ فَإِنْ جَهِلَ هُوَ وَالْمَأْمُومُ. So if they ignored or they didn't know it, him and the ma'mum, till حَتَّى انْقَضَتْ, till it finished, صَحَّتْ لِمَأْمُومٍ وَحْدَهُ, the prayer then in this condition is valid and accepted for only the ma'mum. And then he said, قَالَ وَلَا إِمَامَةُ الْأُمِّيِّ وَهُوَ مَنْ لَا يُحْسِنُ الْفَاتِحَةَ أَوْ يُدْغِمُ فِيهَا مَا لَا يُدْغَمُ أَوْ يُبْدِلُ حَرْفًا أَوْ يَلْحَنُ فِيهَا لَحْنًا يُحِيلُ الْمَعْنَى إِلَّا بِمِثْلِهِ. And it's not accepted for someone who's not valid, the prayer of someone who's illiterate. And the illiterate here, it doesn't mean who doesn't read and write, because the illiterate also can memorize. But in this case, we define the illiterate al-ummi. Al-ummi in this case, he's the one who is not able to read the Fatiha. He's not able to read the Fatiha. And he's not able, when reading the Fatiha, to read it soundly and correctly. And he make the idgham in a place where they should not have idgham, or he changed some of the letters would make change the meaning of it, would make change the meaning. Therefore, he will be reciting a different meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed. And this one on me, he's not, the prayer behind him is not accepted. أَوْ يَلْحَنُ فِيهَا لَحْنًا يُحِيلُ الْمَعْنَى إِلَّا بِمِثْلِهِ. Or he make changes in the words that change the whole meaning. وَإِنْ قَدِرَ And he's, this person, he's better for him to lead someone like him. But if in the presence of people who can read the Fatiha, it's forbidden for him to lead, because in this case, his, the salat of the other will not be accepted. But if both of them, two or three or group, they don't know how to read it, therefore one of them, if he lead them, the prayer will be accepted. وَإِنْ قَدِرَ عَلَىٰ أَصْلَاحِهِ لَمْ تَصَحَّ صَلَاتُهُ And if he able to correct it, therefore his salat is not accepted, because he was, you know, has kind of shortcoming to not have the ability and the, to put the right effort to correct his prayer. قال وتكره إمامة اللحان والفأفاء والتمتان ومن لم يفصح ببعض الحروف And it is disliked. So these people, they know how to recite the Fatiha. But in this case, they have, you know, some people in their, you know, kind of, they were impediment in the way of their speaking. So, قال اللحان, اللحان is the one who changed the words. Type of الفأفأة والتمتام. الفأفأة, he the one who repeat the fa. He will be like saying fa, you know, he's like repeatedly, say the fa before he can say the word or the ta. So he, you know, or keep saying, you know, he's kind of he stand on one letter and be difficult for him to you know to pronounce it. So those also is makruha, not la tasah, but is disliking. وَمَنْ لَا يُفْصِحُ بِبَعْضِ الْحُرُوفِ And some people who cannot, you know, soundly say one of the huruf. For example, some people, they say ta, they can, you know, say it gha. Some people, they say ha, they say it ha, and etc. وَأَنْ يَأُمَّ أَجْنَبِيَّةً فَأَكْثَرَ لَا رَجُلَ مَعَهُنَّ And also, it's not sound or makruh. Or actually, what tukrahu, so also that someone will lead a woman and there is no man with them, ajnabiyya, and she's not a mahram for him. أو قوما أكثرهم يكرهه بحق. And also, it is forbidden for someone to lead people when they do not like him, and not liking him in the way of the Sharia, not liking him based on the wings. And I believe we did all this part. وتصح إمامة ولد الزنا والجندي إذا سلم دينهما and the imam the of someone who's you know who's born out of an illegal intercourse and jundi is a soldier or you know shorty or someone who's like a police or things like that because some of the scholars they say is makruh for them to lead the prayer. For the one who's coming from illegal intercourse, he said, no, it is sound, the imamah, because he didn't have any choice in that. As long as he's a pious person and he has the integrity and he know how to pray and he's good in that, there's no objection actually why he should not be leading. You know, the fact that he's born from illegal intercourse will not, you know, he didn't do that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قَالَ وَلَا تَزِرُ وَزِرَةُ وَزِرَ أُخْرَ Allah will not bear, you know, any person to bear the burden of any other one. Al-Jundi, you know, here, some of the scholars have said it is disliked for the policeman or the soldier. Why? Because he's known in the society sometimes as the people You know, it depends on people who has the power of governance. It's like, you know, they force people or people they feel like, you know, kind of they do not have the choice, you know, to choose someone else because these people have the authority so they cannot speak in front of them or someone who comes to lead so they cannot say no. So in this case, some of the scholars, they said, is disliked for them too. Especially in a state where there's, you know, a lot of transgression, Therefore, it is not right for this, you know, people of authority to lead the prayer. But here in the school of thought that we studying, or the book, or the author, you know, of the book, Zad al-Mustaqna, who's, you know, studying the Hanbali school of thought, said there is no objection for them to lead. There is no objection for them to lead as long as their deen is right. Not because, for example, someone, he has an authority, so he's bad. No, the authority that he is bad, he should not lead. But someone who has authority and a nice, kind person and righteous person, therefore, you know, their imamah is sahih, their imamah is sound. That's why he mentioned it, because some of the scholars are saying he's makruh. قَالَ وَمَنْ يُؤَدِّ الصَّلَاةَ بِمَنْ يَقْضِيهَا وَعَكْسِهِ لا مفترض بمتنفل ولا من يصلي الظهر بمن يصلي العصر أو غيرها. Literally here he's saying, and also ومن يؤدي الصلاة بمن يقضيها وعكسه. Someone who's praying, for example, ظهر on time, and someone who missed ظهر. Someone who missed the ظهر, for example, he's making up for صلاة الظهر of past ظهر. He can join him in the prayer, so they can pray jama'ah together. And vice versa, someone who's making up for a past dhuhr and someone who's going to pray dhuhr on time, you know, he can't be led by someone who's praying dhuhr that he's making up. So, قَالَ وَمَنْ يُؤَدِّ الصَّلَاةَ بِمَنْ يَقْضِيهَا وَعَكْسِهِ لَا مُفْتَرِدٍ بِمُتَنَفِّلٍ. According to this school of thought, someone who's praying obligatory prayer, قال, he cannot be led by someone who's praying nafilah. Who can be? وَلَا مَنْ يُصَلِّ الظُّهْرَ بِمَنْ يُصَلِّ الْعَصْرَ أَوْ غَيْرَهَا. And someone who's praying dhuhr, he cannot be led by someone who's praying asr, and vice versa. Someone, for example, he didn't pray dhuhr, and he enters, he finds someone who's praying asr, and he wants to join him. All of that, as we mentioned last time, this is based on the opinion. So based of this masail, these issues, based on the opinion or on the fact that when the both who go, or those who want to perform the prayer, they have different intention, therefore they cannot be one lead the other one. But we mentioned the majority of the scholar. And we mentioned a hadith, some of the hadith, like hadith of Mu'adh ibn Jabal, that he used to pray with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the obligatory prayer, and then he goes to his neighborhood, or his district where he used to live, and he used to lead them for Salatul Isha, because they finished the work late, and he used to make nafilah, so he was to lead, he used to lead some of the companion praying obligatory prayer, and him praying nafilah, And we have evidence that it is sound for someone who's praying farz to pray behind someone who praying nafilah, and vice versa. قال وعلى هذا, some of the shurah saying, وعلى هذا يعتبر القول بجواز إمامة المتنفل للمفترض هو القول الراجح. The strongest opinion here, that it is valid for someone who's praying obligatory prayer to be led by someone who's praying nafila prayer. فالصحيح أنه لا حرج للمتنفل أن يأم المفترض. But according to the Hanbali school of thought, if there's difference of intention, so they cannot, you know, leading each other, or someone lead the other. But according to the Jumhur and to the, you know, based on the evidence that we studied in the different opinion, the strongest of opinion is, it is yes. Like in the Shafi'i school, it is valid, it is valid. Okay. Do you have any question concerning this? I think that's what we stopped last time. Any question? The next paragraph, قال يقف المأمومون خلف الإمام ويصح معه عن يمينه أو عن جانبيه لا قدامه. المأمومون, those who've been led behind the Imam, they should stand behind the Imam, and it is accepted if they stand on his right side or on both sides, but not in front of him, and not on his left only. So those are the position that are accepted that we're going to discuss and see the opinion of the scholar, inshallah ta'ala. الجماعة تتحقق بواحد مع الإمام. When we have jama'ah, the jama'ah is congregation prayer. Starts with two people, an imam and someone one. But jama'ah cannot be for someone praying by his own self. And we also, someone who's praying by himself in, you know, in a single line. I mean, he's only the only person in a line that we're going to explain it, inshallah ta'ala, and see the opinion of the scholars in that. And then we're going to ask the question, how are we going to be if there's one, how are we going to stand toward the imam if there are two, three, and more. So this is our ruling on the position of the ma'mumin toward with the imam, toward the imam. قال, as we said, يقف المأمومون خلف الإمام. So the sunnah is al-ma'mum to stand, al-ma'mumin to stand behind the imam. And this is when al-ma'mumun are more than one. قال, إذا كان المأمومون أكثر من واحد. والأصل في ذلك قوله عليه الصلاة والسلام في الحديث الصحيح إنما جعل الإمام ليؤتم به. We have the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, why the imam is appointed to be, you know, to be followed, to be followed. So the imam is a guide, he's the one who's leading, therefore people that will be behind him following everything he's doing. So the Prophet ﷺ said, in fact, the imam was appointed, this task was made for the people to follow him. قال والإمام كما يقول العلماء رحمهم الله مأخوذ من الأمام. الإمام is extracted from the word الأمام. الأمام is the front, as they make a line in the house. For example, this is the front of the house. So anything that comes behind him, so the front, the imam, it is the one who will be in the front. Therefore, according to the sunnah, he needs to be advanced and in front of the ma'mumin, in front of the ma'mumin. Therefore, when we read again the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّمَا جُعِلَ الْإِمَامُ لِيُؤْتَمَّ بِهِ. You know, the imam was made or was appointed to be followed. قال معناه أن يكون المأموم تبعا للإمام. So المأموم, he will be fully following the imam. وهذا يشمل ما يكون في الأفعال وما يكون في الصورة. So whatever they do in action and in the way that he's doing, they do the same thing as he's doing. قال يقف المأمومون. Look, he said, قال يقف المأمومون. So المأمومون here is the plural of مأموم. So if there are more than one, they will stand behind him. And if two of them, they stand, they should stand behind him. But if they are standing on his right, the salat is accepted. In hadith Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma annahu lamma qama alayhi as-salatu was-salam ba'da hawiyyin min al-layl wa tawadda'a wa waqafa qala Ibn Abbas faqumtu fa sana'tu mithla ma sana'a an-nabiy sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala an, he was at that time with his aunt Ma'muna, and he was in the house of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He saw after a time in the night the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam stood, and he went and he made his wudu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he stood to pray. Ibn Abbas, he did the same as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قال فقمت فصنعت مثل ما صنع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ثم جئت فقمت عن يساره. And then he came to join the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on his left side, on his left side. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took from his hand and he dragged him from the back, this way, from the back, and he put him on his side. So he came on the left side and he put him on the other side. قال فقمت فجعلني عن يمين. So he made me to be on his right side, on his right side. So someone who ma'mun, he has to have the imam on his left side, and he stand on the right side of the imam. So this hadith gives us the evidence that when someone is standing, he needs to stand on the right side of the imam. قال فدل على أن ميمنة الإمام موقف. لكن إذا كان المأمومون أكثر من واحد فإنهم يقفون وراء الإمام. So if the مأمومون are more than one, then they should stand behind the imam. But if two standing on his side, right side, also is accepted, as we saw it in Hadith Ibn Abbas. But they should be behind him, but standing on the right side, it's fine. As the scholar saying, rahimahullah ta'ala. That's why he said, qala وَيَصِحُ مَعَهُ عَنْ يَمِينِ. That's what he said, وَيَصِحُ مَعَهُ عَنْ يَمِينِ. And it also valid and accepted to stand on his right side. And this is sometimes the situation when there is no enough space, or there is someone who joined, for example, two are praying together and the second one come and join. And sometimes the one who's praying with the imam or both of them, they don't know exactly what to do, they join them and they continue their prayer almost in the same line. So they are on his right side, the salat is accepted. But in some condition, in a tight place, in a place where they need to take the smallest space, around the market, in the street, they get a corner, to not disturb, because it's forbidden to pray in the walkways. So to make, sometimes there's not enough space. So to line up on one side, but the imam is going to be advanced a bit on the those mu'min on the side. فلا حرج. قال وعن جانبي. So it is also valid for the imam to stand, and one will be on his right side and one on this left side. So the second one who comes to join, he can join in the left side. But this is actually a riwayah. I can read some of the sharah to get some of the details on that. قال فإنه لا حرج في أن يقف المأمومان أحدهما عن يمينه والثاني عن يساره. So there is no objection or any blame or any disturbance or shortcoming in the prayer if someone will stand on the right and the other one on the left. قال وهذا مذهب الحنفية رحمة الله عليهم. This is the opinion of the school of thought of the Hanafi school. فَيَرَوْنَ أَنَّ الْإِثْنَيْنِ يَقِفُ أَحَدُهُمَا عَنْ يَمِينِهِ وَالثَّانِي عَنْ يَسَرِ. So according to their opinion, someone, if there are two, someone should stand on his right side and the second one should stand on his left side. وَخَالَفَهُمُ الْجُمْهُورُ رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِمْ فَقَالُوا وَهُوَ صَحِيحٌ إِنَّ الْإِثْنَيْنِ يَقِفَانِ وَرَاءَ الْإِمَامِ بِحَدِيثِ جَابِرٍ وَجِبَارٍ فَإِنَّهُ لَمَّا قَامَ جَابِرٌ عَنْ يَمِينِهِ. صلى الله عليه وسلم وجاء جبار دفع صلوات الله وسلم عليه بصدورهما وراءه. So we have two companions, Jabir and Jibar. They came, and Jabir came on his right side, and then the second companion came and joined Jabir on the other right side. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam kind of nicely put his hand on their chest and pushed them back so they can be behind him. But the Hanafi school, they rely on a hadith of Ibn Mas'ud. Ibn Mas'ud قال والعلم عند ذلك وجاءت طائفة منها أنه لما كان حديث ابن مسعود that he had led two of the companion, but someone was on his right side and his left side. Some of the analysis in the books of in the knowledge of the science of the hadith, and they studied this hadith, saying that this hadith, it seems to happen in the time of Mecca. Why? Because the description of the way of the ruku' doesn't exist anymore. At that beginning of the prayer, before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the believer to put their hands, you know, to grab with their hands their own knees, the knees. Before, they were bent in a state of the ruku', but they put their hand mutbaqatayn. The hand, قال, كان, the hadith, قال المسعد, أن ابن مسعود لما صلى بعلقمة والأسود, he was leading العلقمة والأسود, ركع فطبق بين يديه, طبق بين يديه, والتطبيق, so he put his hand this way, he put his hand this way, so before they used to make the ruku' and they put their hands, you know, between the thighs this way, you know, not مشبكتين, قال مطبقتين, مطبقتين this way, so he make ruku' and he put his hand, you know, by the thighs and strike together this way. And this hadith, you know, having this description of the ruku' make us, you know, make the muhaqqiqin, the analysis, and the scholars, rahimahullah ta'ala, to conclude that this happened in the Mecca time, in the Mecca period. And the Meccan period, it was when, in the beginning, when the salat was obligated on the believers. But later on in Medina, everyone who's praying two or more, they are praying behind the imam. So this description of the ruku' made the scholar to say that this is, was like in early Meccan period, and then it was abrogated. It was abrogated. But when you say it was abrogated, if someone, I mean, the position of ruku', of course, is not done that way. But if two, one come on the right side and one on the left side, so there's no objection, you know, in this case, if it's kind of needed or is a necessity based on the space or something like that, therefore, the salat will be accepted. But in normal state, they should be behind them. So that's why here, قَالَ وَيَصِحُ مَعَهُ عَنْ يَمِينِهِ أَوْ عَنْ جَانِبِهِ, and is also accepted if they stand both on his, you know, both sides, both sides. قالت فكانت سنة مكية أنه إذا صلى الإمام يجعل أحد المأمومين عن يمينه والثاني عن يساره ثم نسخ هذا الحديث بحديث جابر. So it was a kind of sunnah in the early Meccan period for the imam to stand and someone stand on his right side and the second on the left side, and this was abrogated later on, and the imam will be in front and the two will be behind him. قال لا قدامة, لا قدامة, but it's not valid for someone to stand in front of the imam. And if he stand before the in front of the imam, is like he become the imam. But the question is, what if someone pray in front of the imam? His salat is not sahih according to what we read. But sometimes someone needs to look at other opinion, it be in some situation is difficult to, you know, to find a place, you know, especially, for example, in the messages that we have, you know, heaven buildings and everything, and you see sometimes the position where the sister, they pray in a different floor, or you have a masjid, you know, have, you know, the first floor and the second floor, it might be in a position that are advancing the imam, in front of the imam. Here, looking at difference of opinion, for example, in the medical school, it says, they say, it is recommended for the imam to be in front of the ma'mumin. But it's not prohibited for the ma'mumin to be in front of the imam. Why? Because what is the main reason for the imam to be in front of the imam? Of the ma'mumin, what is the main reason? The main reason they can follow him. That's the main reason. So if the ma'mum stand before the imam and he still can follow him, therefore both of the salat is accepted. قال ذهب الإمام مالك إلى استحبابه وأن تقدم المأموم لا يبطل الصلاة. So according to the Maliki school, if the ma'mum will be in front of the imam, it doesn't invalidate his prayer. And Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he came, you know, he wants to have an opinion that is very balanced in a way one look to the difference of the opinion. So instead of saying the one in front of the imam, his salat is completely invalid, or, you know, to say like the Maliki school, he said, no, it's fine, it doesn't. Say it depends on the situation. If the situation is a normal situation, then everyone needs to be behind the imam. If someone, for example, enter a masjid and he sees space in front of the imam and he wants to go in front of the imam and everybody is behind him, so this he applied the opinion here that he had, like his salat is not accepted because he's disconnected from the congregation. But in a situation where there is no place, the whole masjid is crowded in the Jumu'ah prayer, and people they have to line up outside, and outside they might be in front of the imam when you look at the lines. So in this condition, he said, based on necessity, so their salat will be accepted. And this is a good opinion to look at it from a perspective, especially in a society like we live in, where the majority of the masajid are not built as a masajid. So, you know, it's either rent place or buy place or get place and convert it into a masjid. So here we say it is forbidden for someone to be in front of the imam, but if out of necessity, there will not objection, because the main reason for someone to be, for the imam to be in front is to lead and to be followed. So people, they know when he say Allahu Akbar, when someone he joined, he doesn't know he's Allahu Akbar if he's in front of imam. This is for ruku or for sujood, or for going, you know, from sujood to sitting down. So seeing the imam, or following someone who's behind the imam, he knows what are, you know, the stances or the position that he should be in. قَالَ وَلَا عَنْ يَسَارِهِ فَقَطْ وَلَا عَنْ يَسَارِهِ فَقَطْ. And it is forbidden for someone to stand on the left side of the imam. And this is as in the hadith of Ibn Abbas, when Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was young at the time, and he stood on the left side of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he hold from his hand and he make him to make the round and come on, put him and, on his right side. قال ولا الفد خلفه أو خلف الصف ولا الفد خلفه أو خلف الصف. Al-Fadhu is the one who pray by himself. Al-Munfaridu, lonely. So he's not joined into the row. So someone by himself, he cannot stand behind the imam. He need to be on his side, on his right side. Except if it's a woman. If it's a woman, she should be behind the imam. قال ولا الفرد خلفه أو خلف الصف. And someone praying by himself behind the row, also his salat is not accepted. And this is the difference of opinion that we'll study. For example, you enter the masjid, and they are praying Dhuhr or Asr or any of the prayer, and the rows are completed, and there is no way to join the row. You're going to start a new row, you come behind the imam and you stand. According to the author, to the school of thought here, that praying someone by himself on the row, there's no anybody else with him. It is kind of, the salat is not accepted. The salat is not accepted when he did all the action. Here, just to clarify where the difference of opinion of the scholars, because of his intention. His intention is praying in jama'ah. Because if he stands by his own self with his intention that he's praying for his own self, munfarid, not joining the imam, his salat is sahih. So our issue here that we're going to discuss, that his intention is part of the congregation. So what if he's by himself on the last row, and there's no anybody else with him? So qal here, literally, what he's saying, and the salat of someone by his own self will not be accepted if he's behind the imam or by his own self, you know, behind the rows, except if it's a woman. Because if you have like three lines of men and in the back there's a woman by her own self, her salat is accepted. So if it's a man join, and he, there is no place in the third row, and he stands by his own self in the fourth line, his salat is not accepted, according to this opinion. Do we have a dalil and evidence that the salat will not be accepted? They said yes. There's hadith Wabisa ibn Ma'bad radiallahu anhu, and the Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala la salata li munfaridin khalf as-saf. No prayer for the one who's by his own self behind the row. And also there's a hadith of Ali ibn Shayban radiallahu anhu, and the Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in fatala min salatihi wa ra'a rajulan yusalli wahda faqala lahu istaqbilu salah. And another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam finished the prayer and he turned to face the companion and he saw someone praying on his own self in the back. He told them, you should repeat your prayer, or told them, repeat your prayer. Istaqbilu salah. أي قال أعد الصلاة فإنه لا صلاة لمنفرد خلف الصف. صلاة is not accepted for someone praying on his own behind the wall. Therefore here the conclusion that whoever who pray behind the wall by himself even one rak'ah, that rak'ah is not accepted. If someone would join him, then he will start to count the prayer from that person when he joined him, because they start to make one row, he's part of the congregation. And this is the opinion of the Hanbali school. But the majority of the scholar, and also there's opinion in the school of thought of the Hanbali school, that the prayer of someone praying by himself behind the row is accepted. Some of the other scholars said, if he has an excuse, yes. If he doesn't have, for example, he entered the third row, still have places, and he just chose to be on his own in the fourth line, so that his salat is not accepted. But if there is no place, you know, and so that's an excuse, and he joined, so his salat is accepted. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the imam was made to be followed. So if he's by his own in a row, and he could not join any other row, therefore he's following the imam. So why should we not, you know, have him to be part of the jama'ah? How can we then answer the second hadith that the Prophet ﷺ said to the companion to repeat, They said this is hadith has maqal, it has like question mark in it. But the first hadith, it sound hadith, but they give the interpretation of the jumhur. Qala la salata, it means the salat is not fully, completely rewarded. So it's not complete, it's not have, you know, it's very high grade. If you have kind of has a shortcoming, if you pray on your own into the salat. So they mention as example, قال لا صلاة بحضرة طعام وهو ولا وهو يدافع الأخبثان وهو يدافعه الأخبثان أو يدافع الأخبثان. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, no prayer for those who pray, you know, at the presence of food, which is mean like the food is going to distract them by thinking of it. قال ولا يدافعه الأخبثان, and he is struggling with you know, answering the call of the nature. He has like, you know, a need to, an urgency to go to the bathroom, but he's holding and pressuring himself, and he continued to pray. If those people, they pray, their salat is sound. So it is makruh in a way to do it, but salat is sound. And they assimilate the same condition, this same, as by analogy deduction on the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, in which he's saying, La salata li munfaridin khalfa al-imam, there is no, the prayer is not accepted for someone who's praying by himself behind the imam, behind the wall. قالوا واستدل الجمهور بأن هذا المصلي صلى مع الجماعة وفعل ما أمر به. And according to the jumhur, this one, this musalli, he did exactly what the Prophet ﷺ told him, you know, to follow the imam, and he followed the imam. And the Prophet ﷺ, he said that the imam was made to be followed. And this is the evidence of the jumhur of the majority of the scholars. But according to the Hanbali school, as we said, if someone is by himself, he should not, you know, his salat is not accepted. When his niyyah is to be in communication, should he ask someone to join him? That's what we're going to discuss it in the next paragraph, inshallah. Illa an takuna imra'a. Except when if it's a woman, so there's no objection, her salat is sound. إمامة النساء قال وإمامة النساء تقف في صفهن وإمامة النساء and the woman إمام when she's leading the woman she should stay in the middle of the row in the same line. We said already that the women, they have the permission and the Sharia give them the permission to make the jama'ah, the congregation, and it's valid for them. And but how they do it by having to select one among them to lead them according to the criteria that we mentioned. And but she stands in the middle of the line. She stands in the middle of the line, on the same line. الشارح saying here, قال أما النساء فلو كانت الإمامة منهن فإنها تقف بينهن ولا تقف أمامهن. So if they are leading, one of them is leading them, she will stand, you know, between them. And this is the action of the mother of the believer, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, and also Umm Salama. So our evidence in that is the action of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha wa Umm Salama. وَرَوَى ذَلِكَ سَعِيدٌ إِبْنُ مَنْصُورٍ فِي السُّنَنِ Sa'id ibn Mansur, he mentioned this in the Sunan. فَقَالُوا إِنَّهُ لَا يُمْكِنُ أَن تَفْعَلَ أُمُّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَضِيَ عَنْهَا وهي الفقيهة الصديقة بنت الصديق رضي الله تعالى عنها وعن أبيها لا يمكن أن تفعل هذا دون توقيف من النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. by doing that, Umm al-Mu'mineen, the one who is one of the greatest scholars among the companions of the one Allah Ta'ala alayhim, she could not have done this without the teaching and of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Therefore, her action is a hujjah in this case. So her action for us is an evidence, as done also by Ummi Salama radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. Then, يَقُولُ وَيَلِيهِ الرِّجَالُ ثُمَّ الصَّبِيَانُ ثُمَّ النِّسَاءُ كَجَنَائِزِهِمْ. Then how they stand? Behind the imam, the lines of the men, and then the lines of the children, and then come the women. This is how is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ لِيَنِنِي مِنْكُمْ أُولُو الْأَحْلَامِ. That people, you know, of understanding, they will be the first behind me. قال فدل على أن السنة أن يلي الإمام الكبار والعقلاء. So the elders and people of understanding, mainly the people of knowledge, the forbearing people, the people, elders, those who need to be behind the imam. Because if any mistake happened or anything happened, they will be able to treat it, to correct it, to handle it. But doesn't mean, قَالَ, so the Prophet ﷺ said, let be, you know, among you to be behind me, those people of understanding, the elders ones. It doesn't mean that someone need to reserve for them the place. Say, oh, this is for people of understanding. No. When the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did said, so the one who knows that he's able or like most likely, you know, has this type of criteria, he's the one who need to come earlier to the masjid, because you cannot favor someone and anybody else. The one who come early, he's the one who gonna be in the first row. So someone cannot come late and he say like I should be in the first, you know, except, you know, for designated, you know, let's say the imam and the muaddin, and there's, for example, he say like the associate imam, who they come together, so they, because they come at that time, they were in the masjid, but they'll not be able to be, they working outside or things like that. But for the musallin, for someone to come late and to go through the rows because he's an elder, that's not from the sunnah of the Prophet. But his recommendation, the Prophet said, let those people of understanding to be behind you. So those people of understanding is that they have a task to be early in the masjid, so they can occupy that position. And he's saying here, one of our scholars called, some of the people, they understand, when the Prophet ﷺ said, let those elders be behind me, or people of understanding, that they should reserve places behind the imam for those people. And this is not right. Because people in the masjid, they are equal. And whoever will come earlier, he's the one who's worthier of that place. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, his will and intention in this hadith, for those people to hasten and to come early so they can be in that position. So it's like part to complete the whole congregation, those people, they need to be in the first line. If anything happens, they can handle the situation. Here, فَيَتَقَدَّمُ الرِّجَالُ. So we have in the first line the man. Then, after that, الصَّبِيَانُ قَالْ فَيَتَقَدَّمُ الرِّجَالُ ثُمَّ بَعْدَ الرِّجَالُ الصَّبِيَانُ. The boys or the young ones. كَمَا فِي حَدِيثِ أَنَسٍ وَأَبِي مُوسَى الْأَشْعَرِي رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى.
كان وجودي في الحلقة. حكي معك الشيخ خليل. هو خليل اللي أرسل لك رسالة.
طيب نشوف إن شاء الله.
هو أرسل لي رسالة.
طيب نشوف. قال فيتقدم الرجال ثم بعد الرجال الصبيان كما ورد في حديث أنس وأبي موسى الأشعري رضي الله عن الجميع. As is mentioned in the hadith of Abi Musa and Anas رضي الله تعالى عنهم فكان صلى الله عليه وسلم يكون الرجال وراءه ثم وراءهم الصبيان. So who's behind him? الرجال after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and then line the children and then after that the women. This is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The khuntha, the khunatha yakunun bayn al-rijal wal nisa. The khuntha, those who are not known to be male or female, they line up between the man and the woman. It's not often that you find these people, but in case that they exist, the khuntha line up between an-nisa or rijal. Now, back to the what we mentioned, the prayer behind the saf. If someone is praying on his own behind the saf, if someone behind the row on his own. قال, let's finish. قال ويليه الرجال ثم الصبيان ثم النساء كجنائزهم كجنائزهم. We're going to study صلاه الجنائز. And this is how they line up also in the janazah prayer. But this is, inshallah, we'll do it. قال وَمَنْ لَمْ يَقِفْ مَعَهُ إِلَّا كَافِرٌ أَوْ امْرَأَةٌ أَوْ مَنْ عَلِمَ حَدَثُهُ أَوْ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ صَبِيٌّ فِي فَرْضٍ فَفَدْ. Now, if someone is by himself on the last row and come and join him, someone, if he stand next to him, someone who is not a believer. So he going to be considered like by himself. Because someone who is not considered by the Sharia to attend the prayer or to observe the prayer, you know, that he's like doesn't exist. Now, based on this school of thought, I mean on the opinion of the author, that someone when he's praying by his own self, in the behind the row, his salat is not accepted. So the question, he said, what if he has someone next to him? He said, if this person next to him or join him, he is someone who is mukallaf like him, then he becomes a new rogue. So according to the opinion, the salat will be accepted from where that person joined. So if he joined the second rak'ah, he continue, and the first rak'ah he has to make up for the first rak'ah. This is according to the author, right? According to the author, because we said the rest of the scholar, they say no, it is accepted, and we mentioned the evidence. Now, if someone would join him next to him, this is how to explain what he's saying. He's not a believer. He stands next to him. He wanted just to try how the Muslim day pray. In this case, he's being considered by himself too, because that person who joined him is not going to be considered to be making a role. So the row, if a non-believer standing, like people they visit the masjid today, you know, and some non-Muslims, they say, we want to join you. If they join, they are welcome to join. But if they join with someone by himself, he will not say, we make a row. No, that's not his row, but he's considered to be by himself, because that person is not someone who implement the, or to observe the salah. Awin mara'ah. The same if it's a woman. someone comes stand to his woman, so he's still considered like he's praying by his own self. أو من علم حدثا, or someone standing next to him, he joined him, but you know that he doesn't have, he's in state of impurity. أو صبي في فرض ففر, أو صبي, or a young boy, you know, standing next to him in an obligatory prayer, the same hukum. So he's going to be considered like praying by his own self. He's going to be considered like praying by his own self. But we go through some analysis bi-idhnillahi ta'ala in this, in this. So here, the other one is like infiradun, infirad, the fact to pray by his own self, munfaridun, is like is a fact. He's lonely, he's by his own self. And there is another one who's like he's still praying by his own self, you know, in a hukum way, hukmi, so infirad hukmi. Why? Because he joined by other people, but he's still considered by his own self. So when this has happened, in the cases that he mentioned. قال وهناك نوع ثان وهو الانفراد الحكمي وهو الانفراد وصورة ذلك أن يصلي معه صبي. One of the example that he joined him in the last row, a young boy. He still considered, according to the author opinion, he still considered by himself. Why? Because صبي is not an obligation on him to pray. But here some of the scholars they mention and they answer here. قال أن يصلي معه صبي أو يصلي معه كافر أو يصلي معه محدث يعلم بحدثه. Or he joined him, a disbeliever, or he joined him, someone who's in a state of impurity. فهؤلاء وإن كانت صورة حالهم أنهم مؤتمون ولكنهم في الحقيقة وجودهم وعدمهم على حد سواء. I mean, do they join or they not join? They will not solve the issue. He's still praying on his own. فَإِنَّ الْكَافِرُ لَا تَصُحُّ صَلَاتُهُ. The kafir, his salat is not accepted. Therefore, he's not being considered to be joining the thing. وَالصَّبِيُّ لَا تَعْتَبِرُ مُصَافَتَهُ عَلَى هَذَا الْقَوْلِ الَّذِي دَرَجَ عَلَيْهِ الْمُصَنَّ. But the sabi, the child, it will not be considered to be making a role according to the author. قال and then والمحدث كذلك, the one who is in state of impurity, because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا يقبل الله صلاة أحدكم إذا أحدث حتى يتوضأ. Allah will not accept the salat of any one of you if he's in state of impurity till he'll be in a state of wudu. فمعنى ذلك أن المحدث الذي يصلي بجانبه لا صلاة له, وإذا كان لا صلاة له فإنه حينئذ لا تعتبر مصافته. So the one who state of impurity, his salat is not accepted. Therefore, when he join you to the row, he's not gonna help you to make a row. So still, someone he's under the hukum of being, you know, on his own in this last line. وأما الكافر فإنه لا إشكال. Now let's analyze, make our analysis. For the disbeliever, we don't have any comment to add on this because his salat is not accepted. Now, we have two that is remaining. For the one who doesn't have wudu, that also no comment to add. He doesn't have wudu, his salat is not accepted, so he cannot be making a row with the one who's praying by himself, by his own self. Now we have two that remain, is the child, the boy, I mean under the age of puberty here, and the woman. قال فلو فرضنا أنك جئت والإمام في ركعة من ركعات فجئت وكبرت وبجوارك صبي ليس هناك غير. If you come, you enter the masjid, and in the end of the line there is only one boy standing, and you join him. أحدهما صبي. قال ليس هناك وأنت وإياه دون الصفوف هل تعتد بهذه الركعة وتصح؟ If this raka is gonna be sound for you or not? Sound for you or not? قال أم أن وقوف الصبي بجوارك وجوده وعدمه على حد سواء. All the existence of this boy next to you is equal. His existence or not is the same because you're going to be considered praying on your own in the last line. In this we have two opinions among the scholars رحمه الله تعالى. فالجمهور على أن الصبي يعتبر من صلى بجواره غير فذ وصلاته صحيحة. According to the majority of the scholar, whoever who pray next to a boy under the age of puberty, his salat is sound and is considered to be a jama'ah. And the hadith of Ibn Abbas, he the hadith that is our evidence here because he joined the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. That's why he specified the author, he said, قَالَ وَلَا عَنْ فَرْضٍ وَلَا عَنْ فَرْضٍ. That's why he considered the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, it was nafila, he was the Prophet making qiyamul layl. But the jumhur of the ulama, they said, if it was qiyamul layl, so it's will gonna be for us, for evidence for any prayer. And also they added the evidence that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, مُرُوا أَوْلَادَكُمْ لِسَبْعٍ, command your children to pray at seven. At seven. So if he's praying more than seven, so you know the salat will be considered in this case. Another hadith, قال حديث أنس في الصحيحين. That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he entered this house and he prayed for them. قال وصففت أنا واليتيم وراءه والعجوز من ورائنا. So he stood him and this orphan and this, the old lady behind him, and he was young, you know. So Anas next to him this yatim, and they stood behind the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. The yatim was a young boy. Therefore here another evidence that the fact to be joined or to join a young boy in the last line, it make your salat sahiha according to the author. قال مع اليتيم وعلى هذا فمن وقف بجوار صبي صحت صلاته. Based on this, whoever who stand next to a boy, so his salat is accepted. المرأة فيها خلاف. Also, you know, someone to stand next to a woman, it has different opinion. If he is standing by his own self on the line and a woman come next to him, his salat is sahih. And she will be considered a rule. And this is the madhab of Maliki, Shafi'i, and some of the Al-Imam Ahmed, some scholars following the school of thought of Imam Ahmed. And the second opinion is saying the standing of a man next to a woman, it will not, you know, make a role at all. It's going to be considered like praying on his own. And the Hanafi, they want like very stern and rigid in this position, saying in fact his salat will not be accepted at all. The analysis of the scholars, you know, come to this conclusion that he sharing with us. قال the sahih, the sound in this mas'ala. Because in this case, for example, we can take some of the opinion if someone is leading in his house and everything, and you know, some of the women will stand on the same line with the boys, for example, of the young boys, that will be fine. As according to this opinion. But the the strongest opinion in all of this. قال أن صحيح أن الرجال إذا حاضوا النساء لا تبطل صلاة الرجال. If they are very close, the men are very close. Some condition there is no space. So if they are very close, حاضوا, you know, to each other, like line behind the line, so their صلاة is accepted. But if a woman join a man in the same row, she will not make the, you know, start a new row, but he will be considered like he's still praying on his own. And the reason is very clear, because the Sharia here commanded the woman in this case to go behind, to pray behind. Do you have any question here? Any question? So I'm trying to finish this part till Maghrib in the meantime. قال ويليه ومن لم يقف معه إلا كافر أو امرأة أو من علم حدثه أو من علم حدثه أحدهما أو صبي في فرض ففد ومن وجد فرجة دخلها وإلا عن يمين الإمام. So someone will come and he will find a gap in the row. If he finds a gap in the row, he has to get into that gap. He has to get into that gap. قال بل يجب عليه أن يسد ما بين الصفوف. It's an obligation to fill the gaps. To fill the gaps. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم commanded بإلزاق الكعب بالكعب والمنكب بالمنكب. To have, you know, to have shoulder to shoulder, and to have also the kabayn, you know, the ankles to be touching each other, and to not let the shaitan to get between the rows. And based on that, whoever finds the gap, he has to fill the gap. Else that gap is not enough for a person, so should not someone bother people by stressing them or make it so tight so it would make them the whole row uncomfortable. This is a gap enough for a person to fit a whole person. He will join. If it's not, he will not join. Because sometimes people they find like small gap and you want to join, but everyone will be tired and it will be like, you know, uncomfortable for the whole row. So what he caused actually, instead of filling up the gap, he made the whole row to be uncomfortable. It's like, you know, it's whole distraction. And this is what the scholar, rahimahullah ta'ala, they emphasize on this fact. قَالَ وَإِلَّا عَنْ يَمِينِ الْإِمَامِ. If he doesn't find the place, he will join the stands on the right side of the imam. If it's possible. Because if he have a lot of rows, he's not going to cross all the rows and going to join the imam. We're talking about, you know, few rows or one row, if there's no place, he can come and join the imam and be on the right side of the imam. Of course, if he's not going to cause disturbance and destruction. So this is all to not pray on his own. But according to the scholar, the salat is accepted, even if he's prayed by his own on the last line, so he should not do.
About the gaps in the row, who's responsible? Let's say there's there's a line in front of you and there's a space there, and there's a next row is already started, it's already formed, already prepared. Who's responsible to go and fill out the gap? The person right behind it, or is it, who's going to be?
It is actually a race, because that's whoever who going to fill up the gap is going to be rewarded for it.
What if nobody fills that gap then? We all, that role, they all have
So someone who has to get the initiative, everybody get the initiative, but if someone else advances and he leave him, and he get, but everyone need to feel, do that initiative. If there's a gap, someone is praying, he should go for it.
You see times where you're praying, and there is a gap and nobody's filling it, and people are switching their prayer, and there is that gap there. So how do we get, how
That's from the shortcoming we have in our I mean, we need to fill the gaps. Especially this gap is a fitter musalli, but a smaller gap who's going to have the whole row to be tight and make people uncomfortable, that's not considered to be. But the thing is, they have to fill up the gap by getting close to each other. So the people on the right, they have to move left. And the people on the left, they have to move right. So if there's gap, it's going to be end on the end of the line. So when someone is going to come join on the end of the line, so he's not going to have enough space. That's why he has to go to the form a new line. So the gap should not exist in the middle of the line, or you know, in between, you know, or in any part of the line, because everyone they have to move toward the middle. To fill up the gaps. So when the imam say, fill up the gaps, everyone looks not only to his side, but he need to look on the left side. So everyone comes together, on the right, go left side, on the left, go right side, to fill up the gaps. But when they getting ready and their gaps, someone should get to it. The last mas'ala that we'll study today قال فإن لم يمكنه فله أن ينبه من يقوم معه. So all of this, if you see, based on one fact, what is this fact? Is like the fact that someone should not pray by his own self. So the author giving you all the ways to avoid to pray by your own self. So this is based on this opinion. If you consider the other opinion, therefore whoever who join and he start to pray on the last line by his own self, there's no objection for him. But following this opinion, he has to find it. So it doesn't mean that someone when he come late and following the other opinion, he should like be, you know, he will not look at the lines. He need to be sure that there is no gap to fill. There is no place in the last line. And then he has a valid excuse to stand on his own. To stand on his own. Now, here the author given us another solution for someone to avoid to pray by his own. قَالَ فَإِنْ لَمْ يُمْكِنْهُ فَلَوْ أَنْ يُنَبِّهَ مَنْ يَقُومُ مَعَهُ فَإِنْ لَمْ يُمْكِنْهُ. So if he cannot find any place to join the row, قال فيمكنه, he had the possibility to ينبه, to warn the one of the row to help him form a new line. قال because you cannot go through the lines to go to the imams, you know, to join him. And then you just, you warn someone by, you know, holding or touching his shoulder. So he will go back and to join him. And here there's actually where the difference of opinion between the scholars. قال قد ورد في حديث. Because this is going to be considered from helping each other in gaining piety and righteousness, you know. So if someone will be like warned, he will be hastened to help his brother to form a new line. Some people, they say, but you're going to leave a gap in the other one. So he said, helping your brother to not have his salat to be accepted is kind of like greater than to have the gap, you know. Because having the gap is shortcoming, but it is, you know, more mafsada to have your brother not have salat being accepted. So sacrifice the gap for the sake of the brother to have his salat be accepted according to the author, you know, to the school of thought of Hanbali, he will be actually permissible and recommended. قَالَ فَإِنْ لَمْ يُمْكِنُ فَلَهُ. So he has, or he had the option to warn someone so he can stand with him on the line. وَقَدْ وَرَدَ فِي حَدِيثِ عِنْدَ الْحَاكِمِ. But it being, you know, has a question mark in its isnad, in its sanad. وَقَالَ فِيهِ رِوَايَةٌ مُعْضَلَةٌ وَفِيهِ رِوَايَةٌ مُرْسَلَةٌ وَهِيَ رِوَايَةٌ جَدْبِي. It has like, you know, but the hadith is not at the level to extract from it a sound hukum. Why? Because it's a hadith ضعيف. Now, if someone make a sign or warn someone and he will, you know, understand and he goes back and form a line with him in new row, that's good. It's fine. It's good. And if he will not, you know, ask and he will pray, we said according to the other opinion also is good. But when we read some of the scholars, you know, it depends on the opinion they're following. But we take in, you know, the middle opinion, and we, especially the opinion of the scholar. The question here, some of the scholars, they said, we were not encouraged to warn the person. And this is, for example, in the medical school. Why? Because he said, you're going to distract him. You're going to make him lose his khushu. And you're going to have the whole row to be kind of distracted, because you're going to create, you know, to be the cause of creating a gap. So everyone has to move to close the gap. And this is all started by this person who came late to ask someone to join him. So the scholar who's seeing from this perspective, he said it's better that he will not do it and he will pray on his own and his salat is sahih. The other scholar, they see it from different perspective. They say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa ta'awanu al birri wa taqwa. So it's like helping each other to gain, you know, to have, you know, for more righteousness and helping each other on doing good. Therefore, warning your brother, everyone will understand and everyone will have. So it depends on the condition, depends on the perspective from which you see, and both of them, inshallah, are sound and right. But according to the author, the opinion or the option that is recommended is to warn someone to form with you in your life. قال ومن وجد فرجة دخلها وإلا عن يمين الإمام فإن لم يمكنه فله أن ينبه من يقوم معه. So if he cannot find a place, so he had the option to warn someone so he form a new line. فإن صلى فردا ركعة لم تصح. So coming back to the author, he reminded us his opinion. So if he pray on his own self one rak'ah, so that rak'ah is not accepted. وَإِنْ رَكَعَ فَدًّا ثُمَّ دَخَلَ فِي الصَّفِّ أَوْ وَقَفَ مَعَهُ آخَرُ قَبْلَ سُجُودِ الْإِمَامِ صَحَّتْ. Now, if someone, he made ruku', وَإِنْ رَكَعَ فَدًّا ثُمَّ دَخَلَ فِي الصَّفِّ. He entered and he saw the imam in ruku'. He make ruku' on his own. And then After the ruku, he joined the line in front of him. He said, "Yes, salati sahih." If he starts a new row by himself, his salat is not accepted as long as he's by his own. But if someone join him before the imam go to sujood, that rak'ah is accepted. So this is the author opinion. Okay. This is the saying of Imam Ahmad. Why we saying if he starts the ruku on his own and then he joined the row, he's accepted. Why? Because there's hadith. This hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Qal hadithi Abi Bakr. Hadithi Abi Bakr. Hadithi Abi Bakr. Abi Bakr, he entered the masjid and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made the takbir for the ruku. So he made ruku by the entrance of the masjid. And he started to walk while he's still in the state of ruku, till he joined the row. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, "Who did that?" So Abu Bakr, he said, "Me." قَالَ زَادَكَ اللَّهُ حِرْسًا وَلَا تَرَى. May Allah give you more eagerness and fervor in doing the good. Because he wanted, he did it only to be, you know, to join the prayer. He said, "But don't do it again. Don't do it again." So don't do it again. He said, قَالَ لَا تَعُدْ. Don't do it again. Another riwayah, qala la tu'id, don't repeat it, so your prayer is fine. And the other way, qala wa la ta'du, don't like, you know, hasten, like you almost running. And all of it, when you combine them together, is like because you need the tranquility. So the Prophet ﷺ didn't ask him to repeat the prayer, but he told him, don't do it again. So Imam Ahmed, looking at this narration, he said, therefore, when someone is praying by his own self, his salat is not accepted. But if he make, like, start the prayer by his own self, and then he joined the row, his salat is accepted, based on Hadith Abu Bakr. And you see the great fiqh of Imam Ahmed to bring the two hadith together, because the other hadith, he said, no salat for those who pray behind the row on his own. And this hadith of Abu Bakr started the salat on his own and then he joined the row. So we bring them together and said, someone who's praying behind the row, his salat is not accepted, as long as the intention, of course, is to pray the jama'ah. And if he started the prayer on his own and he joined the row afterward, his salat is as accepted. This is the conclusion of the, of the opinion of Imam Ahmed in this. In this issue, in this mas'ala, and the rest of the scholar, as we said, they accept, in fact, if someone, he will pray on his own on the last row, based on the perspective that you mentioned, so he will not cause disturbance, he will not cause distraction for the rest of the musalli, his salat is accepted. And these are both of the opinion. And inshallah, when you enter and enjoy prayer, you have the answer what to do bi idhnillahi ta'ala. Because if you enter and you know you are in your masjid, and you know that your people, they know the hukm, so have someone to start a new row with you. But if you enter a masjid and you don't know anybody, and you're not sure if you're going to, have a sign for someone, you're not going to understand you. Because one time someone showed on one of those videos that you see them on YouTube, inshallah, there's a lot of videos of it, which it wasn't nice. Like a few years ago, I don't know if you saw this video or not. So someone joined, he entered and he didn't find any place. So he made a sign for someone. So that person, stepped back. As soon as he stepped back, the guy who came, he took his place. So the one who made the sign for him, he went back, right? So what he did, instead of standing next to him, he took his place. So what happened? The other person get mad and he hit him in the face. Then he start a fight during the prayer. I don't know if you... So I said, that's the whole answer. Any question, inshallah? the prayer in a few minutes. After the prayer, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, we'll come back here. We'll talk about some option to change the location, if it's going to be convenient for all of you, of course. And then we will have, inshallah, also our sister, mashallah, who joined the Jami'ah. Her name is Marwa, and she's teacher or professor in Arabic language. She will talk to you, inshallah, for 5 minutes for a program that we're going to start, an intensive program of Arabic learning, inshallah, after Maghrib, okay? We'll see you after the Salah, inshallah.